BBC Audio presents Curious Under the Stars, Series 1 to 11, starring Elis James and Emma Sidi.
The village of Glan Don. Sunset. At the dawn of summer, and the 6-foot salmon, the monster fish of small makers, is set alight and pushed out to sea towards its ancestral home, the long-lost kingdom of Gwyddno. Homage done, tradition restored, the sunburnt multitudes bare of foot and chest give generous cheer, fortified by a never-ending supply of beer and wine. The loudest cheer of all comes from Gareth and Diane.
Three cheers for Fish Day!
Three cheers for us.
For us. Hooray!
Contentment. Fluffy bunnies. Yet, only 3 months earlier.
Not to be stormed, even in death's confusion. Remember him, then, for he, too, is a winner of wars. Enduring like a tree under the curious stars. Will you please listen? Honestly, R.S. Thomas, he's one of the true giants of Welsh poetry. Not just Welsh, English too. English and Welsh, British. Not only was R.S. Look, I'm warning you, if you don't settle down, there's going to be trouble. Di? It's me, love. I've been in a bit of a situation. Diane? Hello? Where are you? Diane?
Yeah. Lovely,
what the hell is going on?
Gareth!
Who are you? What's going on?
I know what you think!
You didn't tell me you had a boyfriend.
Husband, actually, me. Who is he?
It doesn't matter. He's leaving. Go.
I'm going. I can't find my pants.
Where did you last have them?
Hang on. There they are.
Thanks. Bye.
Sorry.
Sorry? Is that all you can say? How long has this been going on?
Not long. A couple of hours. 3, tops.
What? Well, who is he? What's his name?
I didn't actually catch his name. Does that make it better? Worse? Somewhere in between.
You just exchanged fluids with a total stranger.
We had quite a long conversation before we... Thank you for not hitting him, by the way.
Well, he was bigger than me.
Not in every department, I can assure you.
What were you thinking?
I don't know. We got talking and...
I get to meet a load of people. I don't end up in a horizontal situation with them.
He had the most amazing eyes.
Oh, well, that explains it.
What's that mess on your shirt?
What? Oh, ink bomb. I came home to change it. Revenge of Year 9.
Oh, that's never going to come out. Let's have a look.
Don't touch me! Don't you dare come near me!
I'm sorry, Gareth. I'm so sorry.
Curious Under the Stars. Gone West by Mike Povey.
Will you be okay today?
Well, I won't come home for lunch, if that's what you mean.
That's silly.
Do you mind me? That's my foot. Oh, my God.
It's okay.
I'm suffocating. I can't breathe.
Exactly how I felt.
What?
Yesterday. At breaking point. Closing in. The same journey, the same destination. I was looking for a light, I guess.
Precious light.
Are we going to be all right?
Don't mention it ever again.
Why don't we go away for the weekend?
Well, we can't afford a holiday.
Well, maybe not, but we could always go...
Oh, no. Not there. Absolutely not. Anywhere but...
The village of the damned?
Everyone's down the beach, I expect.
Or in coffins, waiting for the dark.
I don't understand you. If I grew up in a place like this, I'd be forever coming back.
Well, I suppose it does have a certain charm.
All right, Nob!
God, come on, let's go.
Hey, Nob! It's me!
Oh, Gwyn, hi.
How about you doing, are we?
No, not at all. Good to see you, mate.
Aye, aye. Come back in.
Visiting, yeah. Gwyn and I were in school together, love. Diane, as my wife.
Diane! Here's posh. How are you doing?
I'm fine, thank you.
Where do you live now, Wayne?
London.
Is that right? Foreign country, that is.
Do you still live locally?
Yeah. Got a problem with that?
No, no. It's a beautiful place.
As long as you don't look into the carpet.
Yeah. Still in the army, Gwyn?
I don't need to be anymore. Soldier for life, me. Never off duty.
Oh. So what are you doing these days, then?
I know. Listen, that. Keeping a lookout in general. Everywhere they are. If you know where to look.
Well, that one I wouldn't know.
Of course not. Hey, catch you later, Nob.
Nobody actually calls me that anymore.
He was nice.
Come on, let's pop into the Druid's Rest for a drink.
Is it open? Looks pretty dead to me.
Oh, typical. Closed down.
For sale?
Come on, let's go to this one.
I wonder what the asking price is.
Well, who cares? Nobody in their right mind would want to take this on as a dive.
It must be possible to make a go of it in a place like this.
No, no, it doesn't have the footfall or the traffic.
You see, you're talking like a businessman already.
What are you on about?
Think new beginning.
Are you mad?
I will be if I spend another morning on the tube. You will be if you carry on teaching. Say we sell up
London.
Hear me out.
Way.
We could get close to 400 grand for the flat. Pay the mortgage off. Buy this for what? 200? Plenty left to play with.
Are you serious?
I am so bored in sales.
Well, I don't know the first thing about running a pub.
We could learn.
No. This is a mad place with mad people. Absolutely not. I am categorically saying no.
Sold! To the wide-eyed woman and the man with his head in his hands. Congratulations, you two. Names, please.
Oh, Mr. and Mrs. Bevan.
Mr. Oh, are you Brinley's son?
Yes.
How is he? How's your mum?
Well, both well.
Oh, good. Oh, back for keeps, then? Thought we weren't good enough for you.
Far from it. No. I can't wait to get started.
Make a note. Front door needs adjusting.
Oh, my God. It stinks in here.
Nothing that a lick of paint won't put right?
A lick of paint?
What about a Spanish arch between the lounge and the dining area? Or we could just knock it into one.
Hey, look out! There's a rat!
Don't be silly. It's only a squirrel.
Oh, that's okay, then.
It's gone. Come down from the chair.
You look like a rat.
Baby, stand still a minute. Look around you. Can you see them?
The cobwebs, yes.
All the people who have come and gone over the years. The voices. Can you imagine what's been said here?
This beer's bloody awful. Let's go down the Swan.
Something growing out of the pool table. It's got two heads.
I can see us now, Gareth, standing behind the bar. Good evening, sir. What can I get you?
A pint of lager top and some pork scratchings, please.
Oh, who are you?
Don't be alarmed, Bach. Yeah, you must be the new owner.
Gareth?
Ah, the foam, isn't it? Yeah. I don't usually shave as late as this. God, now see? Quite normal.
Gareth?
What is it?
Call the police.
Well. Gareth Bevan, as I live and breathe.
Emlyn. I mean, what the hell are you doing here?
Do you know him?
Return of the native, huh? Welcome home, boy.
Who are you and what are you doing in our customer toilets?
It's only Emlyn, love, it's fine.
How did you get in?
Well, it was like this. When the pub closed at the end of January, with Christmas a fading memory and spring, a solitary bluebell in the imagination's eye...
Oh, get on with it.
It all got a bit...
Thank you.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.